Hello guys, welcome to your class. This is Sunita. Today we are going to start our chapter 4 of Hornbill English, the landscape of the soul, written by Nathalie Trovoroy. Before starting our chapter, let us see the important terms of this chapter. Our first term is anecdote. Anecdote is a short and amusing story about a real incident or a person. Suppose I'm telling you that honesty is the best policy, so related it, I'm just narrating you a story. You must have heard about that story of woodcutter who lost his eggs in the water in river, and then the water deity appeared before him, and the god gave him first the golden eggs, then the silver eggs, and finally his iron eggs. So such kind of short and amusing stories are called anecdote. Anecdote kya hoti hai? शॉर्ट स्टोरीज़ होती हैं जो अम्यूजिंग होती है, इंटरेस्टिंग होती है, और हम डेली के अपनी बोलचाल के अंदर इन एनेक्डोट्स का यूज़ करते रहते हैं. शॉर्ट स्टोरीज़ होती हैं, हम अपनी बात प्रूव करने के लिए कोई भी किसी भी पर्सन किसी भी रियल इंसिडेंट को सुनाते हैं. सेकेंड इज डेलिकेट रियलिज्म. डेलिकेट रियलिज्म रेफर टू द क्वालिटी ऑफ आर्ट विच मेक्स इट सीम रियल. एनी थिंग, दिस इज द क्वालिटी विच मेक्स एनी पेंटिंग to seem real. Third is figurative painting. Figurative painting is an artwork which is clearly derived from real object. Suppose here on this fireplace there is a candlestick. Okay, so I have seen it, and then same I am just making a portrait of it, just making a picture of this candlestick and fireplace. So this is called figurative painting. Whatever you are just looking at, whatever you are just seeing before you, the same you are just painting. Fourth one is illusionistic likeness. What is this? Now it refers to an adjective of the technique of using pictorial method in order to deceive the eye. You might have seen, like, this is a skeleton. कई बार आपने देखा होगा ना, यहाँ खोपड़ी है, यहाँ पे एक लड़की है, यहाँ पे ट्री बने हुए. सो एक नज़र में जब आप देखते हैं तो कुछ और दिखाई देता है, और जब आप बारीकी से उस पिक्चर के अंदर देखते हैं तो आपको कुछ और दिखाई देता है. सो दिस इज़ ओनली इल्यूजनिस्टिक लाइकनेस. दिस इज़ ओनली टू डिसीव योर आईज. सो सच काइंड ऑफ पेंटिंग इज कॉल्ड इल्यूजनिस्टिक लाइकनेस. नेक्स्ट इज कंसेप्चुअल space. Conceptual space refers to the relation with the abstract than the factual representation. This is the incalculable dimension of the understanding of the concept. This is just an understanding of the concept. So with it, now let us start the chapter. This chapter is being started with an anecdote. Anecdote, I hope you remember. Just now I told you anecdote is a short and amusing story. So this chapter is being started with a very interesting story. A wonderful old tale is told about the painter Wu Daozi. Who was Wu Daozi? When we did our summary, I told you Wu Daozi was a painter, right? He was a painter who lived in the 8th century. His last painting was a landscape commissioned by the Tang Emperor Zhangzong. Okay, commissioned by the emperor means the emperor ordered him to paint such painting of a landscape to decorate a palace wall. And why the painting was made? It was ordered by the king to make a painting on the palace wall to decorate it. Okay, and the painting must be of landscape. The master had hidden his work behind a screen, means behind the curtains. उसने क्या किया? उसने अपनी painting बनाने के बाद उस painting को curtain से ढकवा दिया, so that only the emperor would see it. He did not want anybody to look at or to see his painting. That's why he arranged such curtain in front of that painting so that except a king, nobody could see that. For a long while, for a long time, the emperor admired the wonderful scene. When the painting was ready, the king came to admire the painting, to see the painting. Then for a long time the emperor was busy and he admired to see the wonderful scene. He admired all the wonderful things which were painted by Wu Daozi. Discovering forest. Now what was drawn on the painting? It was forests, high mountains, waterfalls, clouds floating in an immense sky, men on hilly paths, birds in flight. Look, sire. Now who said it? This the painter said this. Sire, what do you mean by sire? Means the king. Said the painter, in this cave at the foot of the mountain. What do you mean by foot of the mountain? Aisa nahi ki pair jo hill ke hain ya mountain ke wo pair hote hain. Like suppose this is mountain. So here this is the foot of mountain, the valley you can say. Dwell a spirit. Dwell means lived. Lives a spirit. Yahan pe mountain ke foot mein kya hai? Cave hai. Aur yahan pe kya hai? Ek spirit rehti hai. Dwells a spirit. The painter clapped his hands and the entrance to the cave opened. Now what happened? The painter, he clapped his hands and then what happened? The entrance of the cave, it opened. The inside is splendid beyond anything words can convey. Now अब पेंटिंग बाहर से तो सुंदर थी ही थी, लेकिन जो केव के अंदर थी वो बहुत ज़्यादा ब्यूटीफुल थी. सो द ब्यूटी ऑफ दैट केव, द इनर केव, कुड नॉट बी कन्वेड थ्रू वर्ड्स. प्लीज लेट मी शो योर मेजेस्टी द वे. हु सेड दिस? द पेंटर सेड दिस, दैट लेट मी शो यू द योर वे योर मेजेस्टी, कि मुझे आपको रास्ता दिखाने दीजिए. मीन्स लेट मी एंटर फर्स्ट योर मेजेस्टी. The painter entered the cave. Painter ने क्या किया? He entered the cave, but the entrance closed behind him. Okay, and then what happened? The door, it closed behind him. जैसे ही painter उस cave के अंदर चला गया, वैसे ही cave का दरवाज़ा बंद हो गया. And before the astonished emperor could move or utter a word, the painting had vanished from the wall. अब क्या हुआ? What was the condition of the emperor? Emperor वहाँ खड़ा है. Okay, उसको यकीन नहीं हो रहा. First thing that he could not believe on his eyes, कि painting के अंदर ताली बजाने से cave का दरवाज़ा खुल गया. Okay, second thing, the painter entered in the cave. Okay, and the third thing, that the door was shut, and the means before he could understand the situation, the painting was lost from the, it disappeared from the wall. Not a trace of Wu Daozi's brush was left. Means अब painting भी गायब हो गई है, Wu Daozi भी गायब हो गए हैं. So that's why there was no sign of Wu Daozi even. And the artist was never seen again in this world. And according to this anecdote, this painter Wu Daozi, he disappeared along with his last masterpiece, last painting only, and he could not be seen again in this world. Means he died. We don't know where he went, but this is the fact according to the anecdote that he was disappeared. Such stories played an important part in China's classical education. Okay, and such stories are an important part. I told you about the writer in PowerPoint presentation. Such stories play an important role in China's classical education. The books of Confucius and Zhuangzi are full of them. They help the master to guide his disciple in the right direction. Okay, now these two writers which are being talked here, like we have this Panchtantra, Nitis, Puranas and Vedas. So in the same way, what is the use of these Nitis, Puranas and Panchtantras? So that we can guide, the masters can guide the students in a right direction. In the same way, they have their own books so that they could understand and they could guide their own children in the same way. Now, beyond the anecdote, they are deeply revealing of the spirit. And beyond this anecdote, which art was considered, contrasted this story or another famous one about a painter who wouldn't draw the eye of a dragon he had painted. Now, in the same way, we have another story. As we have Wu Daozi's story, we have another story. This is all about a painter who did not draw the eye of a dragon which was painted by him. Usne ek dragon ki painting banai, but uski aankhein nahi banai. For fear it would fly out of the painting. Kyunki use dar tha ki kahin ye jo dragon hai wo painting ko chhod ke bhag na jaye, ise dikhai dene lag jayega to ye jo hai wo ud jayega. With an old story from my native Flinders that I find most representative of Western painting. Okay, and see the imagination that native Flinders that I find most representative, that through these two stories we can find out that how the Chinese people, they how they considered their paintings. In 15th century, Antwerp, a master blacksmith called Quentin Matis fell in love with a painter's daughter. This is in another story. Now let us see whether it is also regarding Chinese or European art. Let us see, you'll find it when you'll complete the story. The father would not accept a son-in-law in such a profession. Now this is the same story like we have in Hindi films. So ek blacksmith hota hai. Blacksmith means lohar, who works of iron. So, a blacksmith hota hai and he fell in love with the daughter of a painter. Okay. So, but the painter had an objection that my son-in-law cannot be in such profession, that a blacksmith. My son-in-law cannot be a blacksmith. So, Quentin sneaked into the painter's studio and painted a fly on his latest panel. So, blacksmith ne kya kiya? Like our heroes. उसने क्या किया, दैट ही स्नीक्ड द इन टू द पेंटर स्टूडियो. वो चुपके चुपके से जो है ना पेंटर के स्टूडियो में घुस गया एंड ही पेंटेड अ फ्लाई. उसने फ्लाई बनाई एंड दैट ऑन द लेटेस्ट पैनल. ओके, जो पेंटर्स होते हैं, व्हाट डू दे डू, दैट वो एक पेंटिंग पे जब काम करते हैं, जब तक वो पूरी नहीं होती तब तक वो कहीं और काम नहीं करते, वो उसी पेंटिंग पे लगे रहते हैं. तो उनके लेटेस्ट पैनल होता है कि हाल फिलहाल इस पेंटिंग पे काम चल रहा है. सो ऑन द सेम लेटेस्ट पैनल ही ड्रू अ फ्लाई with such a delicate realism. And delicate realism, I told you, it refers to the quality of art which makes it seem real. तो ऐसी उसने fly बनाई उस latest panel के ऊपर कि वो बिल्कुल सच लग रही थी. That the master tried to swat it away before he realized what had happened. जो master है, जो painter है, उसे swat करने की कोशिश करने लगा, means उसे उड़ाने की कोशिश करने लगा, before he realized that it was no real fly. कि उसे क्या हो रहा था, उसे इस बात का पता ही नहीं चला कि हो क्या रहा था, और उसने उसे उड़ाने की कोशिश की. ओके, सो क्विंटिन वॉज इमीजिएटली एडमिटेड एज एन अप्रेंटिस इन टू हिज स्टूडियो. ही मैरिड हिज बिलवड एंड वेंट ऑन टू बिकम वन ऑफ द मोस्ट फेमस पेंटर्स ऑफ हिज एज. अब क्या है, क्विंटिन वॉज इमीजिएटली एडमिटेड. अब क्विंटिन ने फटाफट एडमिट कर लिया कि क्या हुआ था स्टूडियो में, एंड उसने क्या किया, दैट ही मैरिड विद हिज बिलवड. अ पेंटर जो था वो बहुत खुश हो गया बिकॉज हिज वुड बी सन इन लॉ जस्ट ड्रू अ वंडरफुल फ्लाई ऑन द लेटेस्ट पैनल दैट ही हिमसेल्फ कुड नॉट रिकॉग्नाइज वेदर इट वॉज अ रियल और अ पिक्चर. So these two stories illustrate what each form of art is trying to achieve. So ये जो दोनों stories हैं वो बताती हैं हमें कि हमारी हर एक art form जो है वो क्या करना चाहती है. Now you just see, and this story is quite different from the story of Wu Daozi. Okay, in this story where we are focusing on the realism, on realism. Okay, a perfect illusionistic likeness in Europe. the essence of inner life and spirit in Asia. Now this is the difference here. Asia, China is also a part of Asia. So what is there in Asia? In Asia, the essence of inner life and spirit. Okay. But in Europe, what is your illusionistic likeness? What is illusionistic likeness? I told you, it refers to an adjective of the technique of using pictorial method in order to deceive the eyes. In the Chinese story, the emperor commissions a painting and appreciates its outer appearance. अब वो जो एम्परर था उसने क्या किया था, ही वॉज अप्रिशिएटिंग द आउटर ब्यूटी ऑफ द पेंटिंग, बट द आर्टिस्ट रिवील्स टू हिम द ट्रू मीनिंग ऑफ हिज वर्क. बट आर्टिस्ट ने क्या किया, ही रिवील्ड द रियल मीनिंग ऑफ हिज आर्ट. द एम्परर मे रूल ओवर द टेरिटरी ही हैज कंक्वायर्ड, बट ओनली द आर्टिस्ट नोज द वे विद इन. Let me show you the way, the Dao, a word that means both the path or the method and the mysterious works of the universe. Now the painting is gone, but the artist has reached his goal beyond any material appearance. Now see, this Chinese, what is the difference between the Chinese and European art? जो चाइनीज आर्ट है, वॉट दे बिलीव इन ए सेंस ऑफ इनर लाइफ एंड स्पिरिट एंड दे बिलीव इन इनर ब्यूटी. बट वट द यूरोपियन आर्ट बिलीव, दे बिलीव इन द फिगरेटिव पेंटिंग्स, दे बिलीव इन रियलिज्म. सो अ क्लासिकल चाइनीज लैंडस्केप इज नॉट मीन्ड टू रिप्रोड्यूस एन एक्चुअल व्यू. सो चाइनीज़ जो लैंडस्केप होता है, आई जस्ट शोड यू द पिक्चर ऑफ यूरोपियन लैंडस्केप एंड द चाइनीज लैंडस्केप. चाइनीज लैंडस्केप इज नॉट मीन्ड टू रिप्रोड्यूस एन एक्चुअल व्यू. जो एक्चुअल व्यू आप देखते हो, दैट कैन नॉट बी अ चाइनीज लैंडस्केप एज वर्ल्ड अ वेस्टर्न फिगरेटिव पेंटिंग. आपको अगर ऐसा कोई लैंडस्केप देखने को मिल जाता है जो बिल्कुल रियल लगता है, दैट इज़ अ यूरोपियन पेंटिंग. Whereas the European painters want you to borrow his eyes and look at a particular landscape exactly as he saw it. Now what is the difference between the point of view of Chinese and European paintings? जो European painter होते हैं वो क्या करते हैं, they want you to look at the art through their point of view. They have fixed point of view, fixed, okay? That this is the meaning and you have to see this only. This is the purpose to make the art and this is only you are to see. But from a specific angle, in Chinese, painter does not choose a single viewpoint. And the Chinese, they just make you free. You just think, you just have your own point of view. They don't have any problem. They don't bound you to have a specific viewpoint. His landscape is not a real one and you can enter it from any point, then travel in it. The artist creates a path for your eyes to travel up and down, then back again in a leisure movement. This is nothing like that. This is a real, okay? This is all imaginary. This only just to feel the inner beauty of the art, to feel the spirit of the art. This is even more true in the case of horizontal scroll. I just showed you horizontal scroll as well, कि कैसे वो fold करने से unfold होते हैं तो वो painting दिखाई देती है आपको, और जब वो fold हो जाते हैं तो painting उसके साथ सिमट जाती है. In which the action of slowly opening one section of the painting, then rolling it up to move on to the other, adds a dimension of the time which is unknown in any other form of painting. It also requires the active participation of the viewer, who decides at what pace he will travel through the painting, a participation which is physical as well as mental. The Chinese painter does not want you to borrow his eyes. Okay, this is an idiom that to borrow his eyes. This is an idiom. आई से मतलब ये नहीं है कि आप उसकी आंखें उधार लोगे. आई से मतलब यहाँ पे पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू है. ओके, सो दिस इज़ ऑल अबाउट द चाइनीज़ आर्ट. के चाइनीज़ आर्ट क्या होती है? चाइनीज़ जो हॉरिजेंटल स्क्रोल की यहाँ पे स्पेशली बात हुई है, दैट इज मीन्स आपने फोल्ड करने वाले चार्ट्स देखे. यू माइट हैव सीन, यू मस्ट हैव सीन द चार्ट. तो चार्ट्स क्या होते हैं कि जैसे जैसे फोल्ड होते जाते हैं वैसे वैसे हमारी आंखें ऊपर की तरफ चलती जाती हैं, वैसे उसके साथ हमारी आंखें भी जो है ना, हमारी आंखों से जो मटेरियल है वो गायब होता जाता है. जैसे जैसे उसको अनफोल्ड करते जाते हैं वैसे वैसे उस मटेरियल के साथ साथ, पेंटिंग के साथ साथ, हमारी जो नज़रें हैं वो भी अपना रास्ता ढूंढती रहती हैं. दिस इज़ द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस ट्रैवल. नाउ The Chinese painter does not want you to borrow his eyes. He wants you to enter his mind. वो क्या चाहते हैं कि वो आप उसके mind के अंदर enter करें कि वो कहना क्या चाहता है. Means idea क्या है? What is the basic thing? The landscape is an inner one, a spiritual and conceptual space. I told you conceptual space, it refers to a relation with the abstract, then the factual representation. जो actual representation है उसके साथ imagination का क्या relation है? This is called conceptual space and it must be understood if you are looking at a Chinese painting. So my dear students, half chapter we have done and the rest of the chapter we'll do tomorrow. So till then, thank you and have a nice day.